All the students, welcome to my class. Good morning to all of you. Today's topic is dehydration of ethyl alcohol. C2H5OH is the ethyl alcohol and it is undergoing dehydration. Dehydration means removal of water is called as dehydration. And to carry the dehydration, we are using concentrated H2SO4. Here we are using concentrated H2SO4. The concentrated H2SO4 in this reaction is acting as a dehydrating agent. Remember this one? Concentrated H2SO4 is used as dehydrating agent. What is meant by dehydration? Removal of water is called as dehydration. Yes. In this reaction, if you are observing the reaction clearly, ethyl alcohol, when heated at higher temperature, 443 kelvins, in presence of concentrated H2SO4, the ethyl alcohol is going to lose water molecule, loss of water molecule, and it is going to give C2H4. C2H4 is represented as CH2 double bond CH2. CH2 double bond CH2 is known as ethylene, and the IUPAC name is ethene. So this is a simple reaction of dehydration of ethyl alcohol. But in this class, we are going to study the mechanism of dehydration of ethyl alcohol. Yes, wait a minute. Mechanism of dehydration of ethyl alcohol. Already I sent the PDF to all of you. Whether you checked or not, I don't know. Before my class, I am sending the PDF for your convenience. So today's topic is mechanism of dehydration. Mechanism of dehydration of ethyl alcohol. Mechanism of dehydration of ethyl alcohol. It is having three steps. First step. In the step one, it is the protonation. Protonation. Protonation means addition of proton. Protonation of what? Protonation of ethyl alcohol. The step one is the protonation of ethyl alcohol. Protonation means addition of proton. So first I am taking ethyl alcohol, CH3, CH2, single bond OH. Oxygen contains two lone pairs of electrons. This is the ethyl alcohol. When it is reacting or heated in presence of concentrated H2SO4, H2SO4 is an acid that provides H+ ions. Now, this lone pair of electrons, one of the lone pair, is donated towards the H+ ion of concentrated H2SO4. Then what will happen? Here, protonation of, that is addition of proton is going to take place. Addition of proton is going to take place to ethyl alcohol. Then we will get CH3, single bond CH2, CH3, single bond CH2, single bond OH. And this oxygen is also bonding with this hydrogen. So here I am writing single bond hydrogen. During this reaction, due to transfer of lone pair from oxygen, oxygen is going to lose one lone pair, then oxygen gets positive charge. So this is the alcohol called as protonated ethyl alcohol. Protonated ethyl alcohol. So first step, the first step in the mechanism of dehydration of ethyl alcohol is protonation of ethyl alcohol to form protonated ethyl alcohol. Yes, take the screenshot. Okay, so that is the first step. Now coming to the second step. Step two. Step two is the dehydration. Already we know that what is meant by dehydration. Removal of water is called as dehydration. What is undergoing dehydration? Dehydration of protonated ethyl alcohol. The second step is the dehydration of protonated ethyl alcohol to form a stable carbocation. My dear students, this question is important for PU for 3 marks. Please listen the class carefully. So first I am taking the protonated ethyl alcohol, that is CH3 single bond CH2 single bond O single bond H single bond H. Here oxygen is having positive charge. Yes, this is called as protonated ethyl alcohol. Protonated ethyl alcohol. Yes, if you observe the protonated ethyl alcohol, where the positive charge is present? The positive charge is present on more electronegative oxygen. This is the oxygen, more electronegative oxygen. Electronegative oxygen means that should attract the electrons. So because of the electron deficiency here, this bonded electrons between carbon and oxygen. Once again, the bonded electrons between carbon and oxygen, these two electrons are completely taken by oxygen. Then what will happen? Cleavage of the bond. What is going to happen? Cleavage of the bond is going to happen between carbon and oxygen. Now, here what is going to be removed? If you see this one, what is going to be removed here? H2O. Water molecule is going to be removed. Removal of water molecule is called as dehydration. So once again, I'm writing the same reaction clearly. So first I'm going to take the protonated ethyl alcohol, CH3, CH2, single bond O, single bond H, single bond H, oxygen with positive charge, named as protonated ethyl alcohol. And in the protonated ethyl alcohol, oxygen is having positive charge. As a result, the bonded electrons between carbon and oxygen are completely taken by oxygen. The bond is going to be broken between carbon and oxygen. Then we will get, what we will get? CH3 single bond CH2. Now this carbon gets positive charge. So what is formed in this reaction? Carbocation is formed. Carbon with positive charge is called as carbocation. Plus removal of water molecule is taking place. Removal of water molecule is called as dehydration. So in the mechanism of dehydration of ethyl alcohol, the step 2 is the dehydration of protonated ethyl alcohol to form a stable carbocation. And if you observe here, what is the carbocation formed? CH3 single bond CH2 plus. That is named as ethyl carbocation. Ethyl carbocation, and that is an example of first degree carbocation. First degree carbocation is formed. This is the second step. So second step is the, what is the second step? Second step is the formation of a stable carbocation by the dehydration of protonated ethyl alcohol. Yes, take the screenshot. So in the step 2, what is formed? Ethyl carbocation is formed. CH3 single bond CH2 plus, called as ethyl carbocation. That is an example of first degree carbocation. And also water molecule is formed in this step. Now step 3. In the step 3, attack of water molecule. Here in the step 2, water molecule is formed. That water molecule is acting as nucleophile, and that water molecule is going to attack the carbocation, stable carbocation. So the step 3 is attack of water molecule, attack of water molecule as nucleophile, attack of water molecule as nucleophile onto the stable carbocation. This is the important one here, onto the stable carbocation. So in the step 2, what are formed? Ethyl carbocation is formed. Ethyl carbocation is written as CH3 single bond CH2 plus. Okay, plus water molecule. Water molecule is H2O. Oxygen is having 2 lone pairs of electrons. Now this is the alpha carbon and this one is the beta carbon. Because all of you know, if you consider the ethyl alcohol, ethyl alcohol is CH3, CH2, OH. Functional group attached carbon is called as, the functional group attached carbon is called as alpha carbon and the adjacent carbon is called as beta carbon. So in the ethyl alcohol, CH2 carbon is the alpha carbon, CH3 carbon is the beta carbon. Once again here, CH2 carbon is the alpha carbon, CH3 carbon is the beta carbon. Now in the step 3, what is happening in the step 3? Attack of water molecule as nucleophile onto the stable carbocation. Here I am taking ethyl carbocation. For my convenient, I am writing ethyl group as, CH3. Just a minute. Okay. CH3. This is the CH3. Okay. CH3 single bond CH2 plus. Yes. Once again, CH3 single bond CH2 plus. In this two carbons, this one is the beta carbon. Now, water molecule containing oxygen containing 2 lone pairs, one of the lone pair is donated towards the beta hydrogen. This is the hydrogen called as beta hydrogen. So one of the lone pair of oxygen of water is donated towards the beta hydrogen. Donation of lone pair means this molecule is acting as a nucleophile. If any molecule where the central atom is having the excess electron pairs, once again, a molecule in which central atom having excess electron pairs, if it is able to donate the lone pair, this molecule is acting as a nucleophile. So in the reaction, step 3, water molecule is acting as a nucleophile. The lone pair electrons of oxygen of water are donated towards beta hydrogen. As a result, this bonded electrons are migrated or shifted between alpha and beta carbon. Now, what will be the product? The product is CH2, single bond becomes double bond. Here, single bond becomes double bond, CH2. Actually, here positive charge is there. When this bond is going to be migrated, the carbon valency is going to be satisfied. See this carbon having number of bonds. 1, 2, 3, 4. This carbon is having number of bonds. 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4. So both the carbons are satisfying their valencies by the formation of CH2 double bond CH2, that is known as ethylene or ethene. Plus, what is formed additionally? H2O is going to react with H plus ion. The beta hydrogen is removed as H plus ion. That H plus ion is reacting with water molecule. Then we will get H3O plus. So this is the dehydration mechanism of ethyl alcohol having three steps. Step 1 is protonation of ethyl alcohol to form protonated ethyl alcohol. Step 2 is dehydration of protonated ethyl alcohol to form a stable carbocation. And the third step is, attack of water molecule onto the carbocation to form corresponding alkenes. This is an alkene. So whenever alcohols are undergoing dehydrogenation. Once again, when the alcohols are undergoing dehydration, not the hydrogenation, the alcohols are undergoing dehydration, the alcohols are going to give corresponding alkenes. Right, take the screenshot of this one. Yes, simply I'm writing the three steps. Once again, mechanism of dehydration of alcohols. Very important topic, this one. From this one, we can solve some MCQs. So once again, I'm writing step one, step two, step three in a simple manner. Step one. In the step one, what we are taking? Ethyl alcohol, CH3, CH2, OH, ethyl alcohol. Ethyl alcohol reacting with? Ethyl alcohol reacting with H plus ion of concentrated H2SO4 to give protonated ethyl alcohol. Protonated ethyl alcohol. The protonated ethyl alcohol is written as. This is the protonated ethyl alcohol. Right? In the step two. In the step two, the protonated ethyl alcohol is taken. The protonated ethyl alcohol is taken in the step two. And here, the bond is going to be broken between carbon and oxygen. Now, this bonded electrons are migrated towards oxygen. Then, removal of water molecule takes place and formation of a stable carbocation takes place. Here, stable carbocation is CH3, CH2 plus is the stable carbocation. That is the first degree carbocation is formed. First degree carbocation is formed. That is the ethyl carbocation is formed plus water molecule is formed in the step two. And in the step three, same, this ethyl carbocation, the ethyl carbocation, now that is represented as CH3, single bond CH2 plus, reacting with water molecule again. Here, water molecule is acting as a nucleophile, and this carbon is the beta carbon, and these hydrogens, and this hydrogen is the beta hydrogen. One of the lone pair of oxygen is donated towards beta hydrogen. This bonded electrons are migrated between alpha and beta carbon. Then we will get the alkene. What is the alkene obtained? CH2, double bond CH2. Once again, CH2, single bond becomes double bond, CH2 plus water molecule reacting with beta hydrogen as H plus ion to form H3O plus. So these are the three steps involved in the dehydration. Once again, the reaction is called as dehydration of ethyl alcohol. Dehydration of ethyl alcohol. Dehydration means the mole of water molecule. And CH2 double bond CH2. This is the product. What is the name of the product? Means ethylene. Ethylene is an example of alkene. And C2H5OH. C2H5OH is an example of alcohol. So when alcohols are undergoing dehydrogenation, the alcohols are undergoing dehydrogenation, then the alcohols are going to give corresponding alkenes. Yes, take the screenshot. Yes, once again, my dear students, what is the step one? What is the step one? Text me. What is the step one of dehydration of ethyl alcohol? What is the step one of dehydration of ethyl alcohol? What is the first step of dehydration of ethyl alcohol? Yes, correct. Protonation of ethyl alcohol, correct. So during the protonation of ethyl alcohol, what will be formed? During the protonation of ethyl alcohol, what will be formed? Protonated ethyl alcohol is formed. That is the step one. Step two. What is the step two? What is the step two? Step two is dehydration, removal of water. Dehydration of protonated ethyl alcohol. Once again, the step two is dehydration of protonated ethyl alcohol to form a stable carbocation. That is the step two. Dehydration of protonated ethyl alcohol to form a stable carbocation. That is the step two. Right. What is the step three? What is the step three? Step three. Step three is the attack of water molecule as nucleophile. Once again, attack of water molecule as nucleophile onto the stable carbocation. Onto the stable carbocation. Yes, just a minute. I'm going to share the screen. Already I sent the PDF to all of you. Yes, on the screen. Now you can see the three steps. Mechanism of dehydration of ethyl alcohol. Step one. What is the step one? Yes, step one is formation of protonated alcohol. Step one is the formation of protonated alcohol. Observe carefully. If you understand this concept, remaining things you can easily understand. So step one is the formation of protonated ethyl alcohol, and that is a fast step. Now second step is the formation of carbocation by dehydration. Dehydration means removal of water. So the removal of water is taking place in the second step of the reaction mechanism. Once again, the removal of water is takes place in the second step of the mechanism of the reaction. If you see this one here, between carbon and oxygen, between carbon and oxygen, the bond is going to be broken. So we are studying the chemical reactions of alcohols involving cleavage of carbon oxygen bonds. The chemical reactions involving cleavage of carbon oxygen bonds of alcohols we are studying. The dehydration of alcohols is an example of cleavage of bond between carbon and oxygen to form here a stable carbocation is formed. And coming to the step three, yes, this is the step three. In the step three, deprotonation. Proton means a H plus ion. Deprotonation means removal of H plus ion. Once again, deprotonation means removal of H plus ion. Suppose if you consider this ethyl carbocation, CH3, single bond, CH2 plus ethyl carbocation. And this is the carbon having positive charge, that is considered as alpha carbon. And the adjacent carbon is considered as the beta carbon. Now beta carbon is having how many hydrogens? 1, 2, 3. So beta carbon is having 3 hydrogens here, and the water molecule where oxygen is having 2 lone pairs, one of the lone pair of oxygen of water is donated towards the beta hydrogen. This is the beta hydrogen. Of course, this one is also the beta hydrogen. This one is also the beta hydrogen. All are symmetrical. So I am taking this beta hydrogen. Onto this beta hydrogen, oxygen is going to donate the lone pair, and this hydrogen is removed as H plus ion. Once again, the hydrogen of beta carbon is removed as H plus ion. Removal of H plus ion is called as deprotonation. So how the deprotonation is taking place? By the attack of water molecule as nucleophile. So finally we are getting an alkene. This is the alkene, CH2 double bond CH2, and it is named as ethylene. So during the dehydration of ethyl alcohol, the product is ethylene. Suppose if you are going to take a propyl alcohol, if the propyl alcohol is undergoing dehydration, first what we are taken? We are taken the ethyl alcohol, and the ethyl alcohol is undergoing dehydration by heating at a temperature of 443 kelvins. Remember this temperature, very very important. You have to remember the temperature. In presence of concentrated H2SO4, the dehydration is happened. What is the product obtained? CH2 double bond. CH2 is the product obtained. And IUPAC name of this product is ethene. Ethene is an example of alkene. And here, ethyl alcohol, that is an example of alcohol. So whenever the alcohols are undergoing, whenever the alcohols are undergoing dehydration, the corresponding products are alkenes. And in this reaction, what are removed? What are removed? OH minus ion is removed from alpha carbon. Once again, OH minus ion is removed from alpha carbon, and H plus ion is removed from beta carbon. So two types of carbons are there in the ethyl alcohol. Alcohol containing carbon is alpha carbon. OH minus ion is removed from alpha carbon. H plus ion is removed from beta carbon. Whenever H plus ions are removed from beta carbon, that type of elimination is called as beta elimination reaction. Once again, the removal of H plus ion from beta carbons, the reaction is called as beta elimination reaction. So this dehydration, which type of dehydration? The dehydration of alcohols. The dehydration of alcohols. This is the important one for CET and NEET. The dehydration of alcohols is an example of which type of elimination? Beta elimination reaction. Beta elimination reaction. Once again, I am writing the reaction on the board. Here, ethyl alcohol is taken, C2H5OH. Yes, tell me whether ethyl alcohol is saturated or unsaturated product. Whether the ethyl alcohol is saturated or unsaturated. Can anybody text? Whether ethyl alcohol is a saturated one or unsaturated one? Whether the ethyl alcohol is saturated or unsaturated? Yes, ethyl alcohol is saturated. Unsaturated. Gayatri is saying unsaturated. So, what is meant by saturation or unsaturation? Between carbon and carbon, if single bonds are only present, that is saturation. Ethyl alcohol is represented as CH3, single bond CH2, single bond OH. This is ethyl alcohol. Between carbon and carbon, what are present? Between carbon and carbon, single bonds are present. Hence, it is an example of saturated compound. And when it is undergoing dehydration, what it is giving? CH2 double bond CH2. CH2 double bond CH2, it is an example of which type of compound? Which type of compound it is? Unsaturated compound. When a saturated compound is going to give an unsaturated compound in the reaction. Once again, when a saturated compound is going to give unsaturated compound in the reaction, the reactions are the examples of elimination reactions. Here, single bonded compound is there. Here, double bonded compound is there. So this type of reactions are the elimination reactions. Particularly, the dehydration of alcohols is an example of beta elimination reaction. Beta elimination means removal of H plus ions from beta carbons is called as beta elimination reaction. And in this concept, what we understood is alcohols, when they are undergoing dehydration, they are going to give corresponding alkenes. Right, once again, I'm going to take the next alcohol, propyl alcohol. How many types of propyl alcohols are possible? Tell me how many types of propyl alcohols are possible. What is the general formula of propyl alcohol? The general formula of propyl alcohol is C3H7OH. Once again, the general formula of propyl alcohol is C3H7OH. I can write the propyl group as CH3, single bond CH2, single bond CH2, single bond. This group is called as normal propyl, N-propyl, normal propyl having OH. So the compound is called as N-propyl alcohol. And I can also write CH3, single bond CH, single bond CH3, single bond. What is the group? What is the name of the group? Can anybody say? What is the name of this group? CH3, single bond, CH, single bond, CH3. What is the name of the group? Yes, very good. Isopropyl. When OH is there, now the compound is called as, now the compound is called as isopropyl alcohol. So propyl alcohols are of two types, n-propyl alcohol and isopropyl alcohol. When these compounds are undergoing dehydration reaction, when these two compounds are undergoing dehydration reaction, what will be the products? Yes, can anybody guess? Either n-propyl alcohol or isopropyl alcohol, when they are undergoing dehydration, removal of water is called as dehydration, what will be the products? Of course, I know alkene. Okay, fine. What is the name of the alkene? What is the name of the alkene going to be formed? What is the name of the alkene going to be formed? Yes, correct. Propene. Propene is the product going to be formed. Correct. Exactly. So, ethyl alcohol on dehydration gives ethene. Propyl alcohol and isopropyl alcohol on dehydration gives propene. Now coming to the point, butyl alcohols. So all these topics comes under CET and NEET. Butyl alcohol. Now I am going to consider butyl alcohol. Butyl alcohol. What is the general formula of butyl alcohol? What is the general formula of butyl alcohol? My dear students, the time is very less, 3 minutes more. At the end of the session, before 1 minute, please take the attendance screenshot and send to me. Yes, what is the general formula of butyl alcohol? What is the general formula of butyl alcohol? Correct. C4H9OH. Okay. Remove this OH. Remove that OH. Simply it is C4H9. C4H9 is called as butyl. Butyl. How many types of butyl groups are there? How many types of butyl groups are there? Already we discussed this one in the haloalkanes. How many types of butyl groups are there? Butyl group is written as single bond C4H9. And first we can write CH3, single bond CH2, single bond CH2, single bond CH2, single bond. This is called as normal. Normal means N-butyl. This is the N-butyl group. Now secondly, we can take CH3, single bond CH, single bond CH3, single bond CH2, single bond. What is the name of the group? What is the name of this group? What is the name of this group? Isobutyl. Isobutyl. This is a first degree carbon. So whenever first degree carbon is there with C4H9, having a CH3 group as the substitute. Once again, whenever a first degree carbon is there with CH3 group as the substitute, having the formula C4H9, this is the isobutyl group. Isobutyl group. So isobutyl group. And this is the N-butyl group. Next one. What is the next one? What is the next one? Third one. Yes, the third one is a secondary butyl group. The third one is secondary butyl group. How can we write the secondary butyl? CH3 single bond CH. CH3 single bond. CH single bond. CH2 single bond CH3. CH3 single bond. CH single bond. CH2 single bond CH3. This is called as. This is the carbon. Second degree carbon. Hence it is called as secondary butyl group. And one more group is possible. C single bond CH3, single bond CH3, single bond CH3, single bond. Just a minute. Yes. C single bond CH3, single bond CH3, single bond CH3, single bond. What is the name of the group? What is the name of the group? Tertiary butyl group. The name of the group is tertiary butyl group. So whenever butyl groups are of four types, how many types of butyl alcohols are possible? Four types of butyl alcohols are possible. One is the N-butyl alcohol. N-butyl alcohol is written as CH3, CH2, 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 OH is called as N-butyl alcohol. CH3, single bond CH, single bond CH3, single bond CH2, single bond OH. This is called as isobutyl alcohol. Isobutyl alcohol. And here if I am taking OH, it is called as secondary butyl alcohol. Secondary butyl alcohol. If here I am taking the OH, it is called as tertiary butyl alcohol. So the butyl alcohols, yes, the butyl alcohols are of four types: n-butyl alcohol, isobutyl alcohol, secondary butyl alcohol, and tertiary butyl alcohol. Yes, now the question will arise. When the butyl alcohols are undergoing dehydration, what are the products?